Hello, Mr. Nyren here. So now I'm going to show you how to install Warcraft Total War for Medieval Total War Kingdoms. It's a mod. Okay, so you go to modbay.com and then you search here for Warcraft Total War. And you have one result here, Warcraft Total War. You click there. You will... Let's see again. Warcraft Total War. So you go to the company. Anyway, for members on your members, you can view this profile. I'm not sure. Okay, maybe if we go back to the main page, then search for Medieval 2 Total War. Go to Medieval 2 Total War. And then, but that's not the right. Fuck. Medieval 2. Let's see. Total War. You need to use the number 2 as letters. So two eyes. Medieval 2. Then Medieval Total War. Then mods. Then you'll find Warcraft Total War in this area. Warcraft Total War, Medieval Total War Kingdoms mod, released 2018. Okay. See the details here. Some of the details might be outdated. Okay, then we have an article here. The latest changes and installation instructions. So this mod is now also using the M2TWEOP-tool or Medieval Total War Engine Overhaul Project tool since the latest update released on May 4, 2021. You can find the downloads in the article too. So you can either click here on the article to read all of it and you will find instructions on how to use the tool and everything. And then you have the 4GB patch which is required for the mod to work. And then you also have the actual mod here, the Warcraft Total War official public beta version 2.2. Then you have the info about the latest changes of the mod. Yeah, but you can also just, if you are on the start page, you can also just read the article here, most of it anyway, and you can then go to the download links through the article, or you can scroll down. So down here you find all the articles and then you find the files. So you have the 4GB patch which is required, but it's required for most mods for Medieval 2 in these days. So if you have installed the 4GB patch, if you have applied the 4GB patch on the Medieval 2.exe and Kingdoms.exe of Medieval 2 for any other mod to work, then you don't need to do it again for this mod. It's just it's required if you haven't used it on the Medieval 2.exe or Kingdoms.exe in any other mod to get it to work. I mean Warhammer Beginning of the End Times and Game of Thrones Enhanced or Fire and Blood and Elder Scrolls Total War, Hyrule Total War and Third Age Total War, all of them require this tool nowadays. If you have used this on the main.exe files of the Medieval 2 game in order to get any of the other mods to work, then you don't need it for Warcraft. But if you haven't used it for any other mod to work, then you need to use it on the main.exe files of the game, not the mod. So the mod used to have .bat files. You are not to use the 4GB patch on the mod.bat files. You are to use it on the games.exe files. Okay, then the Warcraft Total War mod. So you click here, then you can download this, but before you do that you need the RAR archive program. So you go to Google, you write WinRAR. The first thing that shows up is this, click here, and then you can download it. And the symbols of all the archives using this program will look like this. And then you can double click on these archives to get access to the files. So you will, in this case, so for example, we have an archive file here. You can either right click on it and extract the folder through these options here, or you can double click here, which will result in the archive opening up. So you can see if we have Warcraft here somewhere. This is the rush and sub mode, but if you click on it, Winds of no, that's Winds of Winter, it's the Game of Thrones one. Okay, anyway, we had a Game of Thrones app, so when you open it, if it's Warcraft, you will see the VTV in the big letters here. Then you can just move it out by dragging it like this. You can also move it out by using the commands here, but I never do that. So, for the CD version of the game, you would go to your computer and whatever drive you have installed Medieval Total War Kingdoms on. In my case, it's the D drive. Then you go to games, because the Medieval Total War game should not be installed in program files, because that might cause many issues with mods, because recent updates of the Windows operative system has made it makes clone files or clone archives or folders of games. If you have, for example, Medieval 2 in this folder, program files x86, then it will create a cloud drive with that folder. So if you do any changes to this folder here, those changes will not affect the game, because you have a clone somewhere on the computer where the game's files are still unchanged. So that's why the Medieval 2 game should be in a different folder than the program files folders. In the past it worked to have it in program files, but I believe an update a few years ago caused this problem, and now we need to have it in a different folder, usually games. I created a folder named games. Then we have Sega, we have Medieval Total War, and we have the mods folder, where you will place the VTV folder, this folder, by dragging it out of this folder. Okay, it will take a while for it to load, because it's a very big mod. And then when you click here, you will have the M2TWEOP.exe file as a part of the downloaded folder. However, the antivirus or firewall of your computer might think this is a Trojan or a virus, so if you don't want it to remove this file, and if it's removed you can't start in mod. So if you don't want that to happen, you need to make an exception for this program, the m2tweop.exe file, in your firewall's settings or in the antivirus settings. All you need, or you can just simply disable the firewall. If you do not have any other mods running already, then you might also need to disable your UAC or user account control. That's done by going to your control panel and then find the area about your user account control settings, and then you can deactivate it. Anyway, when that's done, the mod should work fine on both Windows 7 and 10 if you're using the CD version like I'm doing here. Then you just right click this file and run as an administrator, or you can just double click it, and then everything should already be set. So we have configuration.cfg here of the mod. We have these files checked, don't change them, and then you can change these you can change these things if you want, if you're a modder. But if you're not a modder, I suggest not touching these. So you can change stuff like religion limit and chivalrous limit, etc. But if you're not a modder, don't change stuff. And then you have these files here, or options here, I mean, not files but options. So when you're going to play Warcraft Total War, I suggest disabling spawn army fix and new family tree elements, because having too many options selected will cause heavy lag and stuttering in battles. So deselect these and then click apply changes, and then you can start the mod using only the Berserk's fix and the creature's fix. You need to use the Berserk's fix because it fixes the CTD that happens when units using the Berserk mental state reach the enemy on the battlefield. So the game, the vanilla game, will crash if they have Berserk mental state on, but as soon as they reach the enemy it will crash, but in with this checked it won't crash. Okay, and the creature's fix will make all the giants much more stable on both Windows 7 and Windows 10, but it's required in order to play the new version of the mod on Windows 10 in battles, because the giants and creatures, giant dragons, giants and creatures like snapdragons, fellhounds, etc., scorpions, they crash on Windows 10 a few seconds after camera is centering on them if you do not have this on. That's why we need a tool so we can fix the giants. That's the main reason I added the tool. The Berserk stuff is just a bonus I added as well, but I wouldn't have added this, I wouldn't have added the tool just to get Berserks to work. But the creatures needed to be fixed, you know. I had to disable all the creatures from the campaign because they cost a CTD on Windows 10, and that's a lot of units in Warcraft Total War that are creatures or giants or dragons. So by using this tool they all work in battle without crashing. So now about starting the game. You can start the vanilla game here. Vanilla means the original game, Medieval Total War Kingdoms. You shouldn't click here if you want to start the mod. Instead you should click the upper button, start mod or run mod, and then you will start the mod. And this is on the CD version. Okay, so what's the difference with the Steam version then? Well, on the Steam version, I have Steam installed on the new volume drive. We go to Steam, so it's a different pathway. We have go to Steam, and then we go to Steam apps, and then to Common, and then to Medieval Total War. And here, if you haven't installed other mods already, you might only have the medieval2.exe file. So you need to right click on this file, and then click on copy, and paste it here. Then you will need to rename the copied file, the copy of medieval2.exe. You will need to rename it into Kingdoms, because the Steam version had the Kingdoms expansion as part of the same version, so it wasn't separate. But certain mods require it to be separate. That's why you need to copy this file, paste it, rename it to Kingdoms, and then mods will be able to start if they use the Kingdoms.exe as the exe for the mod. So you need both exe files here, not just the Medieval 2 one. Okay, and then in order to make the actual tool work, I believe for some computers it should work by just make an exception for the tool in the firewall and antivirus settings, or deactivating the disabling the firewall or antivirus, then the tool should work fine. But for some people, when trying to start a mod, because you still place the mod in the mods folder, so it will be Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Medieval Total War mods, and then you place it here, VTV, and it will look the same as the other one. Then we have the tool here, so you need to still make an exception for this .exe file, otherwise it will be treated as a virus and removed to the trash or something. So make an exception in your firewall settings or in the antivirus settings, or disable your firewall and antivirus. Also the UAC user account control should be deactivated. Okay, so then you can start this. But for some people using the Steam version on Windows 10, when they start it, they will still get this screen. You should still make sure that only the creature fix and the Berserk fix is checked here. If any others are checked here, then deselect them. So if they are checked, just click on them to not be selected, and then click apply changes, and it should save. Then the next time you start the tool, they will be disabled. You only need these two, no others. If you use the others, battles might become very laggy and stutter a lot. Okay, leave the other settings as they are and start the mod here. But for some reason, using Steam on Windows 10 with the tool might cause the screen to be a small screen in the corner of your computer screen or TV. And in order to fix this, you will need to go to Medieval Total War, the main directory, and then you will need to right click on the medieval2.exe and the kingdoms.exe, and then you will need to go to properties and to compatibility, and then you will need to follow okay, let's go back to the article. So this picture here, if you right click on it and open image in a new tab, then you get a bigger version of it. Okay, so the first thing you do is you right click on the medieval2.exe and the kingdoms.exe, then you go to properties, compatibility, and then you click on I believe this one, the one that has to do with DPI settings. You can see here, I tried it on Windows 7, no issues. I tried it with the CD version on Windows 10, no issues. But according to the creators of the tool, it is required to change some stuff for the Steam version on Windows 10. You do need to right click on the medieval2.exe/kingdoms.exe and change some things in the compatibility mode. It will also need to be done with the tools.exe file. This is due to the scaling settings in Windows 10. So you need to open file properties, compatibility, and change DPI settings. So click on the one that has to do with DPI settings, and then go to this area and click on it. Then you will get this screen to show up, and you will have to check this area and click OK, and you're done. And check the box and select application. So you need to open file properties, compatibility, change the DPI settings, change the box and select, check the box and select application. And this option also helps with Med 2 for some people. +20 FPS, set DPI scale to controlled by application. Okay, so that will fix the issue with the screen being a small little box in the corner of your computer screen or TV. Okay, and what should I say? You need to do that to both the exe files of the main game, but you also need to go to mods, VTV, and do the same to the M2TWEOP tool. So right click on it and then properties and then compatibility, and then do the same thing here. The reason this screen looks different is because I'm on a Windows 7, and this is only required on Windows 10 if you use the Steam version. Okay, and then start the tool by running as an administrator. Make sure only these two options are checked and click apply settings before starting the mod, then click start mod. And when you click start mod, the mod will start. So we can see the tool there, but it's kind of hidden behind the other text. We have Warcraft Total War here. Okay, thanks for watching. See ya. I don't want any music to be heard in this video. Okay.